sweepings which came out of the 8th Army's spring cleaning at El Hamma, where Rommel's Maritz defense line snapped. Axis prisoners who fell to Montgomery's seasoned fighters. Another pictorial installment in the story of our great advance towards the Tunisian tip, with Pathé cameraman Terry Ashwood and his service colleagues covering the action as Monty works northward through the Gabes Gap. General Montgomery holds one of his informal chats with New Zealanders and men of an armored division. These are the El Hamma boys, the left hookers who handed out the punch which landed fair and square on the point of the Axis jaw. The entry into El Hamma. Tanks of the Hussars and Lancers set the dust blowing through the streets of the little town at the end of round one in the heavy fighting which marks every phase of Rommel's last stand in Africa. This is the triumphant sequel to the bloody grapple that has gone before. Let us for a moment look at the scene of carnage where the opposing forces met in combat. Here in the Udref area, in the open spaces at the southern end of a battle line which runs for 300 miles north to Bizerta, the 8th Army again met and defeated the Afrika Korps in battle. There are many sights like it and more to come. Reward for unflinching, dogged fighting. Gabes and the end of another rearguard action for Rommel's Italians. It was here that General Eisenhower visited General Montgomery at his field headquarters. A friendly get-together on the eve of the Allied link-up between the 8th Army and the Americans moving along the Gabes Road. And here is how a frontline cameraman saw the entry into Gabes. Pipers of the 51st Highland Division doing exactly what they did in Tripoli, leading them in. Keeping pace with our advance, the Navy sends ashore seaborne freight at well-guarded points all along the coast. Feeding, supplying, and sustaining a restless army, which has been on the move for months, now to be counted in years. Try as he would, Rommel was given no breathing space to establish himself solidly. All he could do was to fight stubborn rearguard actions, so that his main force could make for the point where he could link up with von Arnim's army in the north. Our armored elements were forcing him to hot-foot it out of the narrowing defile towards the Wadi Akarit. An unhealthy spot at this time is the Sfax Gabes Road. Under heavy enemy mortar fire, Terry Ashwood gets some spectacular frontline action pictures. Lead up to the pending battle for the Wadi Akarit. A roadside incident. A German ambulance filled with wounded gives itself up. Straggling in the rear of the retreating column, our advance units overtook it. A few distant enemy onlookers saw what happened and, liking the idea, walked in and joined the party. By then, the Red Cross men had their hands full attending to the wounded. And while we're on the subject of prisoners, we show you now some of the thousands hauled in. Between Maref and the fall of Kairouan, 30,000 had been taken. 7,000 German, the rest Italian. Specimens of the master race. Practitioners of Hitler's new order. The preponderance is Italian. A fact worth bearing in mind if Mussolini's navy is ordered to evacuate the Afrika Korps, who so cleverly are using their Latin stooges as scapegoats while the Nazis do the escaping. Each day brings Rommel nearer the end of the road. A road which the Allied Air Forces were making a nightmare for retreat. The biggest joint operations by British and American flyers in concentrated attacks designed to destroy the Axis air arm. Out over the Mediterranean to bomb the aerodromes and harbors in Sicily and southern Italy. Out over every square mile of land where Rommel and von Arnim await their Dunkirk. At 4:30 in the morning, Montgomery launched his attack on Accurate, an artillery barrage which outclassed the preliminary attacks on Alamein and Marath. From darkness into the dim light of dawn, the third great nocturnal massacre was carried out. The Great Rendezvous. On a vast oval plain, hemmed in by sawtoothed mountains, the men who had fought their way mile by mile from Alamein joined the U.S. troops from Algeria. Mission triumph as the Americans link up with the 8th Army for the first time. An American armored unit and a lorry load of British Tommies make a dash towards each other, and a great moment in history is sealed. There is a great combine working together in the Allied merge on the Tunis tip. The stage is set for the last act in Africa and the first scene of another drama.